for what you've done for us. We thank you for saving us and for loving us. We thank you for the opportunity to come together as a church family and pray together, sing together, and worship our great God. To hear from truths from God's word, to be encouraged and ready, prepared to go out in this world and be an ambassador for Christ, as you call us to do. Lord, I pray mostly and lastly, if there's anybody here in the sanctuary today that has never called upon Jesus Christ as their personal Savior, that today would be the day that they would decide to turn to Jesus Christ and call upon the Lord. We ask that it would be done. Lord, I know that there are hurting people here today. I pray that they'd be encouraged and strengthened today. We love you, Lord. We ask this in Jesus' name.
I know.
So we're in John chapter 14, beginning at verse 16. Jesus says, "And I will pray the Father, and he will shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever. Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him, but ye know him, for he dwelleth with you and shall be in you. I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you yet a little while, and the world seeth me no more. But ye see me, because I live." I love this. "Ye shall live also.
Amen.
At that day ye shall know that I am in my Father, and ye in me, and I in you."
Amen.
We need the Holy Spirit. Now, there's one thing about it, though. If you have God with you, and we have the Bible, we have the Word of God with us, don't expect the Word of God to come alive to you if you never read it. And don't expect the Holy Spirit to help you the way He can if you refuse to obey God. So, you know, if you have parents, and parents give you something that you're supposed to do. I remember my day when my mom was like this, and April, she was like, my mom was a really good mom. She cooked at home. We were broke too, you know. And my mom fixed everything scratch at home. And I thought a steak was about that long and round.
Yeah.
And my dad called it a tube steak. He said, "That's a tube steak. That's a steak." So it's just a different kind. And it said sometimes we got a round steak. It was like this, and about an eighth of an inch thick. It was a bologna. And I thought that was a round steak. So I thought, yeah, I was living high. We had steak all the time. That's the way it was, but I will say this, God is not going to help you to do whatever you want to do, but when you obey Him, He'll help you obey Him, and He'll resource you to do everything that He's asked you to do. By the way, the best way to show God that you love Him is obey Him.
Yeah, it's good.
That's the best motive.
Right.
And it's the test of our love. If you say, "I love Jesus," then you want to go do whatever you want to do. God doesn't feel very much love when you just say, I'm going to do whatever I want to do. So our love for Jesus, that's the most important. Jesus prayed. And the Father gives us the Holy Spirit. He says, I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter. The Greek word there is parakletos, that he may abide with you forever. He was preparing them. He was getting ready to leave. He was going to go to heaven. And he's introducing this parakletos to us. Someone called, it means para, alongside us, who cleaves to us. He's the one who cleaves alongside of us. In the original, in Greek literature, it meant an advocate. It meant not just a comforter, literally, but it meant one who comes alongside to counsel you and to be your advocate, to speak up for you. And so he is our defender. He comforts us because he's with us and we're not alone. So he is our counselor, basically. He's our legal counselor, and he's the one that guides us in all the way. I was thinking about a story I read about a 42-foot sailboat, and it was in a very terrible storm. And sometimes, if you've ever been out on the ocean very long, you'll find sometimes it's peaceful, and sometimes it gets really stormy, and the waves get really big. And this was off the east coast of the United States, and this big wave came along. Once in a while, you get kind of a rogue wave, and it flipped the boat clear over on its upside down. But they had a heavy keel, it was a sailboat, and it righted itself. But when it did that, the water snapped off the mast and destroyed all the rigging on the vessel, and they were really in trouble. And so they sent out an SOS on the radio. That was not damaged. And the Coast Guard cutter gets out there to see them. And what the Coast Guard cutter did is, because the sea was too rough, they couldn't rescue the crew off of that boat. So the Coast Guard cutter came up alongside of the 42-foot sailboat and stayed with them. It went on the up the storm, the way the waves were coming. It got on that side and protected the vessel from the brunt of the waves. So the cutter was taking the brunt of it, and the cutter came alongside and guided that vessel back into the harbor. And I think that's the way Jesus is. When the big troubles of life are hitting and impinging upon you, the Holy Spirit can come along. If you're a believer in Jesus Christ, and you, if you love the Lord and you seek to obey him, the Holy Spirit comes alongside of you, and he takes the big hit for you. Amen. And he guides you, and he stays with you, and he doesn't leave you in the middle of your storm. You know people that try to go through life and they have storm after storm after storm. Some of them they bring upon themselves. Sometimes other people bring trouble into their life, but they're trying to go through life without anybody to help them. And that's, Pastor Kirk was talking this morning. I love your Sunday school this morning. It was great. He was talking about all the troubles you have. You know, if you have 50 people in church, you've got this many troubles. And if you have 500 people in your church, you think, oh, great, it's going to be wonderful. There won't be any trouble when there's 500 people. But actually, you got 10 times as many trouble as you had in a little church. And it's, and you begin to realize, I can't do this by myself. You cannot live as a single person, or as a couple, or as a family, by yourself, and accomplish everything God wants you to do, because life throws storms at you. There's obstacles in the way. There's big waves that come along and try to knock you over, but when the Holy Spirit's with you, he's with you through the storm, and he'll help you. The Spirit comes. He testifies. He gives you assurance of your faith. So when the trials come and the storms come and you have doubts that are just natural in your life, you go to God and God will give you peace. He'll give you comfort and peace and strength and guidance and give you answers that you wouldn't have had. It says when he, the Spirit of truth, has come, he'll guide you into all truth. That's what I'm talking about. I'm not making this up. It's right out of the Bible. He shall speak of himself, not speak of himself. Whatever he shall hear, that he shall speak, and he'll show you things to come. If you want to know what's going on and what to do and what not to do, you need to be a born-again Christian first. You need to read your Bible every day. You need to be in church. You need to come to Sunday school. And you need to pray and ask God to speak to you, and he will. He loves it when you say, Father in heaven, Papa. You can speak to him with endearment. You say, Papa in heaven, I love you. Thank you for giving your son for me. Help me, I don't understand what's going on. And he says, well, since you asked me, You know, he'll help you. You can't see air unless you live in Los Angeles or China.
Amen.
You know, I can't see the Holy Spirit, but I want to say air is real. So is TV and Wi-Fi electronic signals. We found that out the other day. Mr. Rogers was pointing out we had a little RF going on there, and it was causing a it went off in the church. Sounded like the sound system burped. I don't know. Something. And it was a Wi-Fi. It was an RF signal that had come into that and got amplified and set that up. It's not normal. Like right now, it's not doing it. Praise God Almighty. You and I can know the Spirit of truth because He's with you all the time. And by the way, the Holy Spirit never, ever will tell you something that contradicts the Bible.
That's right.
Amen. Never, never.
Amen.
Never, never. I'm always looking for it, and I never find it. It always confirms the Bible. Sometimes I can't remember the address, but I remember the words. You ever do that? I remember the words. That's the Holy Spirit teaching you. And by the way, in His version, there's no verses and chapters. It's just all one word God. He just recalls it to you, and chapters and verses helps us remember where it is.
It's good.
The Word of God is what's important. You experience the Spirit. I experience it when I'm preaching. I get up here and I think, I don't have a sermon today. But I prepared it. It's all there. There's nothing in it. I got no zip in it. The zip-a-dee-doo-dah is gone. It's just doo-dah. You know? And then I get up here, and then all of a sudden the Holy Spirit comes. And it's like, it's the Holy Spirit that's doing the work. And I'm just there. So why did Jesus say the Holy Spirit will be in them? In the Old Testament times, it says the Holy Spirit or Spirit of God came upon them to enable them to do the things God told them to do. Now He said He's going to come and dwell in you. He's going to abide in you. He's not leaving. You ever had somebody you counted on that you had a relationship and you had a trust relationship, you thought, and then they left you? That hurts. That hurts a lot. We could just stop right there and pray for each other right there. There's people who have been hurt by other people. And I want to say to you, my friend, my brother, and my sister, the Lord loves you and so do we. And when you have that situation, you want to pray for God to work and do His will and work it out. But we need to be faithful to one another. And the Lord is faithful. He's a perfect example. We have symbols for the Holy Spirit. You know, we have up here, when we lift the screen, don't do it now, but when we lift the screen, there's a bird up there, it's a dove. The Holy Spirit's not a bird, okay? Not. But we use a symbol. I want sometimes to use a dove because it says he descended upon Jesus in the form of a dove. In the form of a dove. Sometimes we say oil, water, light, fire, wind, and He's a seal. The Holy Spirit's a seal. Once you become a Christian, He seals you in the body of Christ. And I think nobody can break His seal. It's the only one you can't break. Because Jesus lives, here's the good news. Y'all think about life and death. The world, you know, I've heard Pastor Kirk Wednesday night. I'm going to get a lot. I take notes from your sermons and your Bible study. Wednesday night he said, don't listen to all the news. It's crazy. Everybody says everything bad is going to happen. This is going to be bad happen. This is going to be bad happen. And you're right about the two news, but if you read the Bible and it goes on and it says, there is a day coming, the day of the Lord. And there will be people praying for the rocks to fall on them, to hide from them. It's going to be bad. But Jesus said, I will not leave you comfortless. I'm not going to leave you alone. I'm going to come to you. Yet a little while and the world sees me no more, but ye see me. Because I live, ye shall live also. There we go. That's it. Because I live, ye shall live also. He'll never, ever stop loving you. He'll never stop valuing you as a human being. He created you for His purpose. Romans 8 says, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, I said troubles are going to come, big waves come, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword, as it's written, for thy sake we're killed all the day long, we're accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, all these things were more than conquerors through Him that loved us. And I love this. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
Nothing can separate you from the love of God. That's why he sent you the Holy Spirit. He's with you. If you're a believer, don't ever feel like I'm alone. You're not alone if you're a Christian.